Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Humpty Dumpty 2. I hope you all are doing great. So today's video is a special video where I'm going to address an important concern that all the new immigrants who plan to move to Canada from any country prefer to move to Toronto initially. Why is that? And why don't people prefer to move to other provinces like British Columbia, Quebec, Alberta, and many more? So in today's video, we will be chatting with a lovely couple who are in Quebec currently, but they did their first landing in Toronto. We will talk to them what happened after their first landing and why did they move to Quebec, how is their experience, and also one important thing, if you know, in Quebec, knowing French is mandatory because it's a bilingual province and they really prefer somebody for any job who knows French already. We will understand from them how has their experience been. Do they know French or how did they go about learning French because they moved to Quebec? Stay tuned to this video if you are a new immigrant planning to move to Canada and still trying to figure out if you should move to Toronto or any other province, because there's a big notion that people prefer to do their first landing in either Toronto or British Columbia. So we'll hear it from the couple itself, and this video is going to be really insightful. So let's get started. Welcome Tushar and Megha to our channel, and thank you so much for taking out time on a Saturday morning and doing this video with us.
Hi, and thanks for inviting us to your channel. My name is Tushar Sharma and I am from Sonipat, Haryana, in India, and I am working here in IT as an SAP consultant.
Hi, I am Megha Mathur and I am from Delhi in India. And I'm working as a tech writer with an IT product-based company. And we had landed in Canada in October 2019 and moved to Montreal in January 2020.
You did your first landing in Toronto and then moved to Quebec. So my next question is, why did you guys, take this move? And how are you liking? Is it that you preferred Quebec more than Toronto, or what was the reason behind this?
Yeah, so it's not about the preference really. We landed in Toronto because we had that federal skilled worker visa. Yeah. So it's like we were open to go anywhere in Canada, or land anywhere in Canada, but we preferred going to Toronto. Why? Because we had a couple of friends over there. Right. And we didn't have any job in Canada when we were coming to Canada, right? At that time, we didn't have any job. And as it is, like, it's pretty obvious, or you can say it's kind of a hype that Toronto has a lot of job opportunities.
That's true.
Right. So that was also a part of it. So that's why we landed there. And I got a job like in a month or a half, I guess. I got a job there
in Toronto.
In Toronto itself. Mm-hmm. We were staying in Brampton, to be honest, right?
We were
in Brampton.
We were
not exactly in Toronto. Yeah.
Yes.
And I got a job over there, but then I was not liking that. And then I applied on another job, which was in Montreal. And I applied there and got selected. So we moved to Montreal. It's not like that. There were no preferences as such.
Right. Yes, there were no preferences. Yeah. It was just that when it came to the job, we felt the one in Montreal was, a better opportunity compared to the one back over there in Toronto. So yes, that was our main reason for moving from there.
Right.
Quebec. Yeah.
Which city do you like most, Toronto or Montreal?
So basically, I would say we were lucky enough to see both the cities.
Yeah.
And if we compare it, when we landed, we stayed in downtown Toronto for a few days.
Yeah.
So Toronto is more of a modern city and it's a bit fast moving as well. But when you see Montreal, it's just, historic places and historic sites, and and the architecture is beautiful here. The natural beauty is incomparable. So that is what we love about Montreal at the moment, because it's extremely scenic. And we stay in a place called Verdun in Montreal. And, we just have a river that is close by, so we can go anytime. So these things were sort of not possible back in Toronto or in the GTA,
True.
So that is why I think we like Montreal better at the moment. Yeah.
Actually, I agree on this point because when you search for pictures on, you know, on Google related to Canada, I think there are more pictures from Quebec because it said that Quebec is one of the most beautiful provinces in Canada, right? Yeah.
And yeah, so it's extremely beautiful. And since we stay in Verdun, the proximity to downtown is just like hardly 15, 20 minutes by car.
Okay.
So, you know, we can go anytime and you have the old port of Montreal, which is extremely beautiful. And, you know, you'll notice it in all of the photos. So we have been extremely fortunate, I would say. Yeah.
Right. That's good. So wherever you are, if you're happy, then there's nothing like that.
Yeah, exactly.
How about the living expenses? If you compare Quebec with Toronto, which one do you think is more expensive?
Yeah, I'm gonna answer this question.
Yeah.
So actually, you know, cost of living is cheaper here in Quebec in comparison to Ontario or Toronto, for example, right? And the main thing is the renting of a house part, right? Because we have to spend a lot on that. That is a major expense out of your pocket. So if I give you just an example. If you are living downtown, near to downtown or in downtown, in Toronto especially, right, it's going to cost for a 1 BHK apartment, it's going to cost somewhere around 2,000.
Correct.
Right. Yeah. But if you compare it with here in Montreal, like we are living in Verdun, which is like 4.3 kilometers from downtown, and we are paying 1,300, which is still a bit expensive,
right?
As because we didn't know when we were coming here that it is that cheap. So it's a bit on a higher end, right? 1,300, but to be honest, it's like up to $1,000 a month is a common rent expense. Yeah, it's a standard rent expense here
for one BHK.
Right?
Oh, okay.
And apart from that, like in the transportation as well, if you get a pass in Ontario for a transport pass or kind of thing, that's gonna cost you like 155, and it's almost half here in Montreal. It's $85 a month.
Right.
Such expenses, like it's just slashed like 50%. Phone bill is $80 there, $80, somewhere around $80 in Toronto, and here it's 40, 42.
Oh.
So it's much cheaper here. However, in groceries, if we talk about the groceries and stuff, I don't see much of a difference there.
Okay. That's great to hear. And what about taxes? Because Ontario, I think, has the maximum taxes, right? How about Quebec?
So Quebec has more taxes than Ontario, actually.
Really? Oh, okay.
Yeah. So again, it's somewhere around, it's like 2 or 3% more, I think, compared to Ontario.
So let's talk about job opportunities in Quebec. How do you think is the job market, and how much time did you both take to finally land a job in Montreal?
So I started applying for jobs in June of 2020. Before that, I was just taking it easy and relaxing at home. When I started applying, I applied for limited positions, which were mostly related to my background.
Right.
And so then I realized that, you know, the number of calls I was receiving was a bit less. So I had to, you know, apply for similar type of job opportunities, not exactly what I was doing back in India. So I started applying for more positions, you know, applying for at least 10 to 15 positions in a day. And then I started hearing from recruiters. So it took me approximately 4 months to land a job. I got a job in November of 2020. And I had given, I think, over 30, 40 interviews.
Okay.
I didn't lose hope, and at times I was a bit disappointed, but I kept giving, and the confidence level increased gradually.
So
that's how my experience has been. And I would just suggest that don't look for your exact background, look for similar job opportunities, because they are there in the market. They might ask for French. So some recruiters did call and ask me, do you know French?
But
there are still opportunities out there.
Correct. Right.
So I saw this job posting on LinkedIn when I was in Brampton. It was more suitable to what I was doing, what I wanted to do. So I applied there, and that company was looking for people of that particular skill set, and that's so I just got lucky and got that job like in a little bit sooner, I say, like, yeah, 1 or 2 weeks.
Right. And that's the reason you moved from Toronto to Montreal, right? Because you got
that is that. Yes.
Megha, you already mentioned that people look out for French. And if I say it from my experience, when we were scouting, in fact, we are scouting for opportunities. And when we look at any opportunity in Montreal or Quebec, for that matter, we see that they've written that, you know, knowing French is a mandatory condition. And most of the time we just rule it out and say that, you know, we are not eligible because we don't know French. Do you think French is really mandatory to know if one needs to find a job in Quebec?
So most of the times when they do mention that you should know French, maybe they're really keen on it. But I would say still go for it, apply for those positions, because you don't know who all are applying for it and how important it is for them at that point to recruit somebody. So keep applying for the positions, and at least the least that can happen for you is that you're gaining confidence from that interview. So I would say that, you know, you can try it, but yes, there are 50-50% chances, I would say, of them actually calling you. And yes, at times they do call you and ask you, do you know French? And then you'll say no, and they'll be like, okay, sorry, we are looking for people who do know French.
Yeah.
There are positions that do not ask for French as well, that it's not necessarily a requirement. So there are jobs like that too right now in the market. So so there are opportunities for non-French speakers here.
Oh, just Montreal. To add one thing to it, like, so, you know, Montreal, here in Montreal, most of the jobs, there are a lot of jobs in IT sector.
Okay.
And when I say IT sector, that is mostly on, like, you know, like you're working on some kind of a tool or something like that. So if you are from that background, then knowing French is actually not mandatory.
Okay. Right? Yeah.
Yeah. But if you are anything
more into sales or marketing,
sales, accounting or marketing kind of thing,
so that might be a requirement. And they do take it seriously.
They just put it there in all the JDs which are coming from Quebec province, right? So there are chances you might convert it as well. Is there any support from the government that anybody who comes to this province get a support in terms of, you know, free courses to learn French, or are there any paid courses or anything that you want to share from your experience?
So when we came to Quebec in January, I got to know that the government does offer French classes and programs, and which is basically free. So you have different types of programs that the government offers according to your convenience. So you have full-time classes, you have online classes, you have part-time classes as well. And I think they have added an employment-based sessions as well. So I think that is more for people who are in government services or medical services. So basically it's free, and applying for it is very easy. You know, you just have to give them certain documentations and, you know, they get back to you, and it's all done online. So it's very convenient. Basically, if you're working, you can go for the part-time classes, which is online at the moment.
So I think there's a link to this website also. I'll put that in the description box. So we got that from Megha herself. So for our viewers, whosoever is interested in checking out that, or maybe planning to move to Quebec, can check out that link and get to know about these courses as well. How is the salary structure in Quebec if we compare it with Toronto? I understand living expenses are cheaper in Quebec when you compare it with Ontario. But if we talk about salary, how is it there?
So it's quite different in both our cases, I would say. So when I was applying for positions over there, and what they were offering me, or what I was getting to know, in Toronto, it was a bit less for me, personally speaking, but I'm getting a higher package over here in Quebec. So I think it's based on a person to person basis.
Okay.
She got more here in Montreal.
Basically I come from a non-tech background.
Yes.
So Montreal turned out to be lucky in my case.
Yeah.
In terms
But for me, it was like, I took a pay cut when I was shifting from Toronto to here. Yeah.
Right. So can I say that the salary structure is better for non-technical jobs and just because there are more job opportunities for IT skill, there the package is normal, right? And if you compare with Ontario, it's a bit on the lower side. Can I say that?
Yes, I guess in a sense, yes. But again, even for technical people, there are certain companies like product-based companies, right?
Okay.
So if you get a chance to get into like this AWS, Amazon or something like that, right?
Right.
You will definitely get a lot better package.
Correct.
Like if you are someone who has background in gaming or things like that, like gaming, designing games.
Exactly.
They fetch a lot of bigger packages.
Montreal is apparently the gaming hub of Canada.
Okay.
So anyone into developer roles or anybody enjoying doing that, this is the place to be. Yeah. Gaming is a big thing over here in Montreal.
In Montreal specifically. Oh, that's good to know. And I specifically feel that there are a lot of job opportunities in entire Canada for developers, especially for app developers. And like you mentioned, gaming developers and all of that, right? So if you know that, it's an upper hand. Yeah. Would you like to share some tips based on your experience with our viewers who plan to do their first landing in Quebec or maybe looking forward to a permanent settlement in Quebec itself?
So the first tip I would give is that if you're, for instance, if you're looking out for a house or for an apartment or some place basically you want to rent. So basically you have Facebook Marketplace, which was very helpful for us. Our friends told us about it. So not only did we find our current apartment online, we basically even had the virtual tour of it from Toronto itself. So we didn't even look at the apartment. We basically had, our landlords gave us a virtual tour of the apartment. We loved it and we even paid for this in advance.
Okay.
So we basically had an apartment before we even moved over here. But yeah, but yes, I will, you have to be a bit careful of who you're giving your money to and things like that. It's basically a trust factor. So when we spoke to the landlords, we felt that trust. So we decided that, yeah, it's a perfect apartment. It's very close to downtown. So Facebook Marketplace is really good for that purpose, for finding apartments and even maybe furniture. If you're looking for some furniture apartments at reasonable prices, because even we purchased our entire bedroom set and, you know, it costed us very less compared to if you go and shop it in the store.
From my side, I'll say get your documentation in line. When I say documentation, it's more on your RAMQ. So apply for the health card as soon as you land here. You're going to receive it after 90 days, but you have plenty of time before 90 days where you can go and submit all your documents. So you don't have to go afterwards, right? Then the driving license.
Mm-hmm.
This is, I took it very not seriously.
Yeah.
You're changing my license and I'm feeling that now. So what one should do is basically when they land here, they just should take an appointment with the transport authority and get their licenses changed to the Quebec one.
The third tip we would like to give is about negotiating when you rent a place.
You can
always negotiate with your landlords. You know, they do listen to you, and the way the market is working right now, it's like a renter's market. So don't forget to bargain. At times you can even, they even ask you if the apartment is furnished. So they do ask you if you want that option. Do you want that as an option? Do you want to keep the furniture? So that way a new immigrant does not need to spend on buying the furniture. So they might charge you a nominal fee of maybe, you know, $40-$50 per month for that.
Right.
But that is a really good option and we opted for that. So basically, make sure to, like everyone says, edit your resume according to the job description. That does work out. Make sure to apply for similar positions. Don't go for, you know, I was doing this in India and then, you know, and come here and have that same thought process. I'm going to only keep myself limited to these positions. No, apply wherever you can. Make sure to edit your resume. It can get a bit tough, but that does work out in the end.
Last thing is that, you know, you can also enroll for certain gap courses once you land Canada.
Yeah.
So there are certain gap or bridging. They are known as bridging courses, I guess. So whatever you were doing in India.
Okay.
And the equivalent of that in Canada might require some kind of a certification. Okay. Some kind of qualification, right?
Right.
And those courses are available on almost all the universities' website and online courses. Mm-hmm. So you can apply for them. They're not very costly. They are very cost effective and you can do it.
And so, that will just add value to your resume.
Yes.
Because while I was looking for jobs, because I saw the competition was so fierce, I decided, you know, I should upskill myself and, you know, maybe I should learn a bit more. So I joined the University of Toronto for a course, which was all online. So I joined the learning design program. I finished two parts of it, and recruiters do take interest in it.
Okay.
They do want to know that, yeah, you're learning and you're not sitting free. So small things like that, whatever can help you.
So finally, I'll say thank you and goodbye to both of you. Hope you have a nice weekend and we get to meet each other when we come to Canada and when we come to Montreal. So definitely. Hoping for that. Yeah. All right. Thank
forward
you.
To meeting you as well.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Hey guys, I hope this video would be really helpful to you, because we just had a quick chat with the couple itself who lived in Toronto and then moved to Quebec, living in Montreal currently. And they shared all their experiences heart to heart with us, and you know how the journey has been and how things are from their perspective if they compare their experience when they were in Toronto and now when they are in Montreal already. So do let us know in the comment box if you have any questions. You can also reach out to us on Instagram. Like I always say, do come by, drop by, visit our page, and do let us know for any queries on Instagram itself. We would love to address your queries and see you there. And do subscribe to our channel if you haven't subscribed already. Click the like button if you enjoyed watching the video, and there are more informative videos to come in future for all the new immigrants, which is going to be really helpful. So stay tuned to the channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, you take care. Goodbye.